film is The Ninth Cloud, and I'm Jane Spencer, and I'm the co-writer and director of the film.
Jane, it's fantastic to have you here at Raindance. What does it mean for you to be a part of this year's festival?
I'm very, very excited. It means a lot. We shot here in England, and I'm excited that we're back. And it's kind of a cutting, not cutting edge, but kind of a more arty film, edgy film, I hope. And because of that, I think that it's good for us to be at this festival, because this is a very artistic, cool festival, and I really like it. And like I said, I don't have to wear a dress. So to me, that's great. Okay.
For people who haven't seen the film, can you just give us a quick synopsis, the story, and kind of what the film's really all about?
Well, thematically, it's about kind of not accepting what circumstance throws at you and create your own world. And everybody kind of creates their own world in this film. And our lead character kind of pushes through her reality, let's say, over what's happening to her. I know that's very thematic. It's not plot. It's a kind of a story of a girl who's trying to reconcile a tragedy in her life. And so she tries to create another world that she lives in. And she decides to put all her hope onto Michael's character, Bob, who's a dishwashing poet. And so she kind of gives him all these qualities that that he has, but that she kind of overdoes it. She thinks he's just, you know, the great artiste of the universe. And then, you know, it turns out that towards the end of the film, we find out she becomes his muse, in a way. So that's kind of the idea, that everybody has their own universe that they live in and tries to make sense of the world. I wanted to do something different with that kind of role. I didn't want to cast somebody that you would think would be Lord Byron, you know? That would be... And the interesting thing was, Michael actually is a poet. And I was very surprised to find that out. So he's a poet, and he's playing kind of who he is, in a way. He's not really the guy with the gun. Actually, my producer and actress, Wendy Thomas, found her and said, you've got to come see this actress on the West End. And I saw her in, she was understudying Keira Knightley in The Misanthrope, and we went, and then we had a meeting with her and cast her in the movie. And it was really lucky. She's really good, I think. She kind of became this person, because she's not that person, but she became this very... you know, she really put everything into it. I thought it was really good.
What do you think independent cinema gives an audience they perhaps don't get from commercial blockbuster fare?
Spiritual things. Character, real thought-out characters. Unusual situations that are more like life than, let's say, blockbusters, like Transformers, perhaps. And that sort of is, you know, I think, I wish that more films, big budget films, would kind of take an artistic edge too. Like Lawrence of Arabia was, in my opinion, an art film. Big budget art film. But I think Raindance is extremely important and cool, and a great festival with, you know, movies that, I mean, like Asia Argento's film, I can't wait to see that. Some very unusual films, and I wish they would be the mainstream.